Closed captioning for the Casey Malone Show is sponsored by Hunter Stevens Land Title Agency. Integrity, service, and commitment you can trust.
Oh yeah. Casey Malone is serving up local. It's time for the stories of our region, the tastes, the sights, the sounds, and the people in and around the valley. Get ready for some local flavor on the Casey Malone Show.
Today, it's Thanksgiving Palooza. We prepare Susie's Kentucky Derby Pie, smashed potatoes, carrot soup with coconut milk, and farro and wild rice salad. But let's start with the turkey breast. Well, this is going to be a really busy show. It is the Thanksgiving episode, and I have been cooking and trying all these recipes and really getting prepared for this segment. Oh boy, this kitchen is going to be a nightmare. But right now, you don't know that. It's all clean and very pristine. And I'm going to have a special guest. Susie White is going to come in a little bit later on and make her Kentucky Derby pie. Oh my gosh, it is so delicious. It'll be a nice alternative to the pumpkin pie for dessert. I've got a farro wild rice salad I'm going to be making, my garlic mashed potatoes, and I'm going to be making a ginger carrot soup, which will be a really nice starter for the meal. Now, I am a big fan of the dark meat, but almost every time I have Thanksgiving, there's never enough breast. So I am going to cook a turkey breast for those that are having a smaller get together or that needs the additional white meat. And this is going to be the star of the show. Usually turkey breasts tend to cook dry, and I think I have solved that problem by draping it with bacon. For this recipe, you'll need 1 6-7 pound bone-in turkey breast, 1 stick of unsalted butter softened, 1/4 cup of chopped sage leaves, zest from 1 lemon, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of ground pepper, and 8 slices of good quality bacon. So I really had to familiarize myself with turkey breasts. And boy, I'll tell you, poultry really is kind of a ugly thing to work with. So we have the breast. This is about 7 pounds, and I rinsed it really well and the inner cavity and dried it with a paper towel. Now I'm going to pick this big flap of skin up that goes towards the neck. And what you want to do is open up this area between the skin and the breast, and you want to be careful not to tear it. And that is where the handy dandy spoon comes in. You get a teaspoon and you really can kind of lift it and get into that area without tearing it. Now, I made sure my butter is super soft. I even zapped it in the microwave for about 20 seconds just to make sure it's really soft. So finely chop your sage leaves, add that to the butter. Also throw in the lemon zest. This really is a nice brightening agent for that. And about a teaspoon of salt, okay? And that's good. And then about 1/2 teaspoon of fresh ground pepper. There we go. Now I'm just going to mash this all together. See, because the softer the butter, the easier it'll be to spread it between the breast and the skin. And now we start the dirty job. And that is taking this in, going underneath, and we're just going to put this all throughout the top of the breast. And it is a bit messy, but after we get it all in there, we'll even it out from the outside, but you just want to make sure it gets in there. So this will take a couple of minutes. So now the turkey is all prepped. We've got the butter massaged throughout. You can see it's lining between the breast and the skin. And now for my bacon lattice. This is going to be a beautiful presentation when it's done. So you lay your bacon down on a board. And so right now we have it going up and down. Then we make a lattice. So every other strip, see, like that. and then we'll go the opposite way. 4 and 4, that's all you need, because the breasts really aren't that big. So we put it underneath, see? And this makes a really tight seal when you go and put it over the bird. And now we just lift this all up. One little piece fell, don't worry. And then you just drape it, just like that, over it, see? You don't have to adhere it with toothpicks or anything, because once it starts cooking and browning, it just shapes and takes the form of the turkey breast. Now I preheated the oven to 425. It will go in for 1/2 hour, and then we'll reduce it to 375, and it will cook for one additional hour, and the bird's done. It'll be right there at 155, 160. So let's get this in the oven.
The Casey Malone Show will be right back with more local flavor.
I am here with Rude the Dude from the Magic Tree Pub and Eatery. And Rudy, you really take eat, drink, celebrate seriously.
Yes, we do, Casey. Not only in our regular pub, but we have a banquet room, party room. We seat 25 to 150. We cater for private parties, meetings, banquets, showers, reunions, you name it, we can do it. We got you covered. Private menus, special menus, anything you need, Chef Reggie can work it out for you.
I just love the idea that you have the entire room if you need it and a private bar. In fact, my class reunion from the Academy is going to be held at the Magic Tree Pub and Eatery.
And we thank you guys for coming. Like I said, it's, you know, our motto is eat, drink, celebrate. We like to specialize and help you out and do everything we can to make your memories last long.
Stop by, they will prove it. Here's to the Magic Tree.
Salute.
At the Vein Center and Med Spa, we realize the serious health issue varicose veins can cause. We know it's more than just cosmetic. We provide you with caring and personal service in a clean and friendly atmosphere. All vein procedures are done in our office during convenient and flexible hours by a medical doctor with over 20 years experience. The Vein Center and Med Spa also offers fillers and neurotoxin procedures, hydrofacials, and laser hair removal services. Call the Vein Center and Med Spa for a free consultation. See why our patients leave satisfied. Now accepting Anthem and Highmark.
Hi, I'm Elizabeth Bernard. I've been giving the people of our valley free advice for 30 years, and my message has never changed. If you're involved in an automobile accident, don't try to handle it yourself. Call a lawyer. A lawyer will be your representative, dealing with doctors, medical insurance, and all the red tape that you may encounter. Hiring a lawyer doesn't mean you'll end up in court. And remember, there are no upfront fees on personal injury cases.
That's good advice. Need a lawyer? Learn more at ElizabethBernardLaw.com.
Mayflower Woolham is your full-service, independent insurance agency. We work with several insurance companies to offer you choices for your insurance needs. We'll find the right product at the right price. Personal, business, farm, life, trust Mayflower Woolham. You focus on what's important, we'll take care of the details. Mayflower Woolham, close by with 3 locations to serve you.
$5 Burger Mondays at Sadie's Place, inside the Best Western, Route 46, Austintown.
Here at the Upstairs, we cater to everyone. When you come through the door, I treat you as though you're my friend. So there's all kinds of options here at the Upstairs. There's something on that menu for everyone. Great food, friendly service, very clean restaurant. There's a lot of restaurants, a lot of good restaurants in our community. So I always feel honored when someone comes here. I want everybody coming through that door to leave here with a good experience.
Ruli Brothers is way ahead of the competition. Check out Ruli Spice World, where you can buy bulk herbs and spices, plus candies, nuts, and fillings for pennies on the dollar. Shop Ruli Brothers, home of the famous Evening Express.
Now this dish can be prepared ahead of time and refrigerated or served at room temperature. And I'm going to say this is an homage to my friend Jill, Remember earlier we made the farro salad together? Well, ever since, I've been obsessed with farro. I really like the nuttiness of the grain, and I found this recipe. It has wild rice. This is so chewy and nutty. It really works well with the farro. And we're gonna put in some dried cranberries, some chopped green onion, and then as a little pop, I squeezed tangerine juice. But if you want, you could just use regular orange juice. But this is a very easy recipe, and it's really tasty, really filling, and I think it'll be really a pretty presentation on your Thanksgiving table. For this recipe, you'll need 4 sprigs of fresh thyme, 4 cups of vegetable stock, 1 cup of wild rice rinsed, 1 cup of farro rinsed, 1/3 cup of orange juice, 1/2 cup of extra virgin olive oil, 4 green onions, white and green parts, chopped fine, 1/3 cup of dried cranberries chopped, and salt and pepper to taste. The farro and the wild rice both take about 40 to 45 minutes on the stove. So we'll just prepare this now. It is going to be 2 cups of the vegetable stock, and then the fresh thyme. You can always add more. And then you'll need an additional cup of water for the rice, okay? And we'll put this on the stove until it comes to a boil, and then we'll add the rice, cover it, and simmer for about 45 minutes. Now the farro boils as the water does. So this will be 2 more cups of broth. You're gonna use your saucepans on this recipe. And then it will be 1.5 cups of water, because it needs a little bit more. Let's see how I did. I don't have my glasses on. Okay, I am a little short there. So we're gonna do 1.5 cups of water. There we go. We'll throw in the rest of the thyme, and then we will add. We'll put this on the stove, making a mess here, and we'll bring this to a boil and then reduce it. But this also takes about 45 minutes. All right, so the farro, and the wild rice cooked and brought to room temperature. Want to make sure it's nice and cool. So we've mixed that together. Look how beautiful that is. Now we have our tangerine juice, but you could use orange juice. But I went that little extra mile, because it is Thanksgiving, and I'm gonna make the dressing. I'm going to just add the olive oil, and then a little bit of salt, a couple grinds of pepper, and we are gonna just mix this and get a nice dressing. So I'll pour that in. Now, you know what would also be good with this? Orange sections, fresh pineapple chopped up. Now we'll add the onion, and we'll wait for the chopped dried cranberries, and we'll do that at the very top as a garnish. And then we just, oh my goodness. You can always add more of these too, because I probably ate 1/2 of these already while they were sitting on the counter. And that's it. That is our wild rice and farro salad. Now this is a great make-ahead dish. Keep this in the fridge and just throw it on the stove right before your guests arrive. It is my carrot soup with ginger and coconut milk. I do not want everyone on Thanksgiving to show up at my house and fill up on snacks, the cheese, the crackers, the nuts, and all that stuff, because of course everyone's starving to eat Thanksgiving dinner. So even if you don't serve this as your first course, it's a nice thing to hand them a mug, and they can have this nice, warm, filling soup, and then they'll be ready to move on to the meal. For this recipe, you'll need 5 tablespoons of unsalted butter, 1 medium onion chopped, 1 shallot chopped, 1.5 pounds of carrots peeled and sliced, 2 teaspoons of ginger peeled and grated, 1 teaspoon of cumin, turmeric, and coriander, and 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne, 4 cups of chicken stock, 1 14-ounce can of unsweetened coconut milk, 1 lime zested and juiced, and chopped cilantro for garnish. Now this is really easy. It's really a one-pot meal. After you've chopped all these vegetables, now we're gonna start with the onion, add that to the melted butter. The 5 tablespoons have already melted nicely. I like shallot because it's not as strong as garlic, but it's pretty close. So the shallot is chopped, and now we're just going to coat them with butter. Now we're going to add the carrots. That's a lot of carrots. But this soup is such a pretty orange, you're gonna really like it for Thanksgiving. We're going to add the cayenne. And we're going to add the cumin and the coriander and the turmeric. I love the spices. I love Indian food. I love Indian spices and the ginger. This adds such a freshness to this dish. You are gonna love it. It's been about 15 minutes. This smells amazing and everything is softening nicely. So what we're gonna do is add our 4 cups of stock. That's one box. Now what we're gonna do is turn this heat back up to high and we're gonna bring it to a boil and then let it simmer for about 20 more minutes. Everything has softened up super nicely. It smells so good in here. So now what I'm gonna do is just turn this off and instead of going to the blender or whatever, or food processor, if you have an immersion blender, please use it. And we're just going to stick this in and make sure that we smooth the soup completely. So now this is all broken down and the carrots are all pureed. And it really looks beautiful, but it's time for the coconut milk. And this gives it another dimension of flavor. It is really good. And we'll just pour this in, make sure it's unsweetened. And then we'll just mix this further, warm it through, and the soup is done.
The Casey Malone Show will be right back with more local flavor.
To own a business where your name's on the window can be pretty cool. That's my family. My name is Danny Cotullo, and I'm the owner of Cotullo Prime Meats. My grandfather started the business in 1962. I was able to take our old style butcher shop and bring it out to the new age using e-commerce to get our products to more customers. When we started shipping, there was not a ton of information out there. That's where we really worked with FedEx so they could be able to help us with our perishable shipping. We were taking on new purchases that we never had to make before. Boxes, coolers, ice packs, anything that was involved around shipping. So we can no longer do this with the cash that we had on hand. So because of the Plum Card from American Express and all of its benefits, it was a natural fit to help grow our business. And when someone calls and lets you know that you made their dinner, that's satisfaction that you can't get anywhere else.
Open the Jewel Box, the Courthouse Inn, organic vegetarian comfort food, handcrafted cocktails, fine wine and beer, fresh baked cakes and pies. Recharge your senses at the Courthouse Spa. Dazzling dining, artfully prepared, locally sourced ingredients, spa services. The Courthouse Inn feels like a world away, just down the road in historic Lisbon, Ohio.
I am blessed with a wonderful husband. He stuck with me through thick and thin, and he's a fantastic father. So when he needed long-term care, not just any place would do, we did our research. Everyone said, trust the name you know, Briarfield. With all those locations, there's always one close. That made it easy for me and the kids to visit more often, Briarfield.
Trust the name you know, Briarfield, proudly serving the Valley for over 20 years.
I personally feel that Fretmark is the best because only 1% of diamonds can even become a Fretmark diamond.
Diamonds take millions of years to be formed in the ground, and it's not very pretty. Once you get to that inner core of the diamond, it really can give beauty and light.
Fretmark goes beyond the technical qualities of the four C's. They handpick diamonds that are truly beautiful.
Get real, get Kamara.
4 for 5 till 6. Happy hour at Sadie's Place inside the Best Western, Route 46, Austintown.
At Ruley Brothers, the family is in the store. Meats, deli, produce, even the checkout. We work hard to ensure that you get the best products at a personal shopping experience. At Ruley Brothers Markets, our customers are our top priority. Our family is in the store.
Now, this dish is very, very easy. I did not even peel the potatoes. If you use a Yukon Gold, or if you use, you know, russet,
or the little reds,
make sure you scrub them really well and just chop them, because it's actually healthier.
Oh, it is.
If you leave the jackets on the praties.
That's the most.
So this is really got a lot of iron in it.
Yes.
So this is about 3 or 4 pounds, and I'm going to make them garlic mashed. I'm not even baking the garlic first. What I'm going to do is add 7 cloves of garlic to the water when I boil the potatoes. And that's it. So when I go to smash them, it'll smash right in with the potatoes, and the water will kind of absorb some of that garlic flavor. For this recipe, you'll need 3 or 4 pounds of Yukon Gold or russet potatoes, scrubbed and cut into chunks, 7 to 8 cloves of garlic, 1 cup of buttermilk, 6 tablespoons of unsalted butter, and salt and pepper to taste. So I've got a pot of water on the stove, added a little bit of salt to it. It'll be about 20 minutes once it comes to a boil till they're fork tender. You want to throw those on?
I certainly do.
All right. Easy peasy. And don't forget to add the garlic. All right, so the potatoes with the garlic have been boiled about 20 minutes. And Jelaine, you are just doing a wonderful job.
Oh, yes.
Look at you mashing it up. I heated this cup of buttermilk. You want me to just pour it in? Yep.
Yep.
And then we'll go like that. And I think buttermilk has a tang, and it really works well with mashed potatoes.
I remember we always had buttermilk in the house growing up.
More butter. I mean, it is Thanksgiving. We're grateful for butter. I love butter.
I do too.
Don't waste your time with that non-butter.
Well, they tell you it's better for you in moderation.
That's right, in moderation. And then I'm going to throw in a little bit of salt. Not too much, because you can always pass it at the table. And then a little bit of ground pepper mop. There you go. Okay. You're gonna taste it. What do you think?
Perfect.
Well, we saved the best recipe for last. And this is Susie White. She is an amazing, amazing cook. And we all got together during Kentucky Derby.
Oh, yeah.
And she went to University of Kentucky, so she does know a thing or two about the Derby. And you made this pie that is so delicious. It's chocolate with pecans. And I mean, I have been thinking about that. Now, that's been since May.
Right, first weekend in May.
Is that the first time you made that pie?
No, it was not. I think I made it a few times when we lived in Kentucky, a few years back.
I loved it. For this recipe, you'll need 1 pre-made pie crust, 1 cup of sugar, 1 stick unsalted butter melted, 6 tablespoons of all-purpose flour, 2 large eggs beaten, 1 ounce of bourbon, 1 cup of pecans, and 1 cup of semi-sweet chocolate morsels. This is my break time. Susie's here to do a little of the work.
Okay.
And you don't even need a mixer for this.
You don't. All you need is a trusty whisk.
Okay, so how do we assemble this?
All right, first thing you put in is your sugar, and you will then mix it with flour.
All right, so our dry ingredients first.
Yep, just give it a good mix.
Okay.
And then you're gonna add the melted butter.
Would you like me to do that
yes,
for you?
Yes, thank you, as I'm mixing.
Okay.
Okay, kind of gets a little bit like a ball of dough.
Well, I was surprised that you don't even have to melt the chips.
Right, right.
You know, I was thinking you'd need like a double boiler and you'd have to do that. So you know.
No, the chips as well as the pecans are kind of like your last minute additions, as well as the bourbon.
Yay!
Yeah, this is the good stuff in the middle. This is like the goo. Next.
Now I think, you know.
It's the bourbon.
One for us, one for the pie.
It's generally 1 ounce.
You know,
so whatever you like more or less. Always a nice addition. The
presentation
going so easily.
Yeah, and you chop them lightly, but you still want them pretty big.
You want some big ones. I prefer to chop just a little bit to make sure that there's like pecan in every bite.
Yeah. So we dump that in.
Yes.
You don't want to overwork the batter, right?
The batter, no. Mm-mm. It's a very easy pie to bake.
I cannot believe this. I'm shocked. Now, we preheated the oven to 350.
Correct.
We're going to put it on a cookie sheet. And 55, should we start checking it? It says 55 to 60 minutes.
I always check at the beginning of the time. If you need to add more, it's way easier to do that than take away.
Well, Susie, I mean, you made a lovely gravy from the pan drippings because I did not have the energy. And I'm really, thank you guys all for coming to my early Thanksgiving.
Lovely.
And our special guest is Sunny.
Thanks, Sunny.
Sunny, do you have a special toast?
Yes.
How about this one?
Thank you.
I'm going to say, here's to us, none better. All right. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
The Casey Malone Show is sponsored in part by Denise and John York and the DeBartlow Corporation.